Everyone, welcome to commercial arithmetic class. So today we will see the last set of problems on laws of indices. So I'll be giving the notes which includes all the problems that we have solved these many days. So today I'll be solving some of the important problems that have been asked in the previous year question paper. So the first problem, I have solved it. It's an easy problem. You guys can work it out. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. So the 37th problem, this is the general form of the 26th problem that we have solved. So even I have solved this problem, you guys can solve it. So all these problems I have solved. And 39th and 40th problem, you guys work it out, or even 41st. So now let's see the 42nd problem. The question is, solve x raised to a upon x raised to b whole raised to c into x raised to b upon x raised to c whole raised to a into x raised to c upon x raised to a whole raised to b. So in the first step, we are using the second law, that is a raised to m upon a raised to n, which can be written as a raised to m minus n. So using the second law, we will get it as x raised to a minus b whole raised to c into b raised to b minus x raised to b minus c whole raised to a into x raised to c minus a whole raised to b. So in the next step, we are using the law a raised to m whole raised to n, which can be written as a raised to m into n. So we'll get it as x raised to a into c minus bc into x raised to b a minus ca into x raised to cb minus ab. So in the next step, we are using the first law, a raised to m into a raised to n, which can be written as a raised to m plus n. So here the base is x, so it is the same for all the three terms. So you are adding the exponents of all the three terms. So you'll get it as x raised to ac minus bc plus ba minus ca plus cb minus ab. So here you can see AC and CA will get cancelled. Similarly, plus CB plus BA and minus AB will get cancelled. So we'll get it as x raised to 0, and we know that anything raised to 0 is always equal to 1. So the 43rd problem is, solve AB root of x raised to A upon x raised to B into BC root of x raised to b upon x raised to c into AC root of x raised to c upon x raised to a. So even this is an easy problem. You have to understand that a b root can be written as 1 upon ab, just like square root of some term can be written as x raised to 1 upon 2. So these both mean the same. So similarly, in this step, we are using this idea and we are simplifying. Let me erase it. Okay. So the first step is x raised to a upon x raised to b whole raised to 1 upon ab into x raised to b upon x raised to c whole raised to 1 upon bc into x raised to c upon x raised to a whole raised to 1 upon ac. So again in this step we are using the second law. So we'll get it as x raised to a minus b whole raised to 1 upon ab. Similarly, the remaining two terms we are using the same law. So in the next term, in the next step, we are using the law a raised to m into a raised to n, which is nothing but a raised to m into n. So So we'll arrive at this step, that is x raised to a minus b upon ab into x raised to b minus c upon bc into x raised to c minus a upon ac. So in this step, we are using the first law. Since the base is same, that is x, so we are adding the exponents. So we'll get it as x raised to a minus b upon ab plus b minus c upon bc plus c minus a upon ac. So here you can see the LCM, which is a, b, c. So using LCM, we will get this step, that is x raised to a minus b upon into c plus b minus c into a plus c minus a into b whole divided by a, b, c. So we are multiplying c to each term similarly in these two steps. So we'll get it as x raised to ac minus bc plus be minus ca plus cb minus ab whole divided by abc. So again the common terms will get cancelled. So we are remaining with x raised to 0, which is nothing but 1. So these are all the similar problems which wherein we'll be using the laws of indices. So you just have to be aware when to use which law. So the next problem is solve 1 upon 1 plus x raised to b minus a plus x raised to c minus a plus 1 upon 1 plus x raised to a minus b plus x raised to c minus b plus 1 divided by 1 plus x raised to a minus c plus x raised to b minus c. So we have to show this whole term is equal to 1. So in the first step here, we are using the second law. By using the second law, we can write this term as x raised to b upon x raised to n, and this term as x raised to c upon x raised to a. Similarly with these two terms. So here in this step, we are taking LCM. So we'll get it as x raised to a plus x raised to b plus x raised to c whole divided by x raised to a. Similarly in these two terms, the LCM is x raised to b and x raised to c. So in the next step, when the denominator goes to the numerator, so we'll get it as x raised to a upon x raised to a plus x raised to b plus x raised to c. Similarly for these two terms. So here you can see the denominator is same for all the three terms. So you can write it as x raised to a plus x raised to b upon x raised to c whole divided by x raised to a plus x raised to b plus x raised to c. So both the terms will get cancelled. So we got the answer as 1. So this problem is an important problem because they have asked in previous question papers for more than 2 times. So the question is 2 raised to n plus 2 raised to n minus 1 whole divided by 2 raised to n plus 1 minus 2 raised to n. So this is a 2 marks problem. So in the first step, you can write 2 raised to n minus 1 as 2 raised to n into 2 raised to minus 1 by using the first law of indices, because the base is same. So when you add again, you will get back to this term. So using the first law, in the first step we are writing the numerator as 2 raised to n plus 2 raised to n into 2 raised to minus 1 whole divided by, similarly here 2 raised to n plus 1 can be written as 2 raised to n into 2 raised to 1 minus 2 raised to n. So here you can see in the numerator 2 raised to n is common. So in the next step, we are taking 2 raised to n as common. So we'll be remaining with 1 plus. So 2 raised to minus 1 can be written as 1 upon 2. In the denominator, again 2 raised to n is common. So we can write it as 2 raised to n into 2 minus 1. So in this step, I'm taking LCM. So we'll get it as 2 raised to n 2 plus 1 by 2 whole divided by 2 raised to n. So this 2 raised to n will get cancelled. So we are remaining with 3 by 2. So even this is an easy problem. This is a 2 marks problem. So the next problem is, even this is an important problem for 5 marks. The question is, solve x raised to l upon x raised to m whole raised to 1 upon l into m into x raised to m upon x raised to n whole raised to 1 upon mn into x raised to n upon x raised to l whole raised to 1 divided by n into l. So like in the previous problem, we will be solving in the similar way. The first step is by using the second law, we can write this term as x raised to l minus 1 whole raised to 1 upon lm. Similarly, these two terms. So in the next step, again we are using the law, a raised to m whole raised to n can be written as a raised to m into n. So we'll get the first term as x raised to l minus 1 upon lm. Similarly for the next two terms. So again by using the first law of indices, the base is same, so we are adding the exponents. So we'll get it as x raised to l minus m upon lm plus m minus n upon mn plus n minus l upon l nl. So in the next step, we are taking the LCM. So here the LCM is lmn, and in the numerator we'll get it as l minus m into n plus m minus n into l plus n minus l into m. So in the next step, we are simplifying the numerator, and again we can see that all the terms will get cancelled. So we'll get the answer as x raised to 0, which is nothing but 1. So this is also an easy problem. The next problem you can solve it in the similar manner, but here just note that here when you use the formula a raised to m into a raised to n, we'll get it as a raised to x minus y into x plus y. So if you remember, a square minus b square is nothing but a plus b into a minus b. So using that formula, we have to solve. And in the last step, again we are using the first law. So we'll get the answer. So the last problem is, if a raised to x equal to b raised to y equal to c, and c raised to z equal to a, then show that x, y, z equal to 1. So in the first step, consider a raised to x equal to b. So in the first class, we had seen a law whereas a raised to x can be written as a raised to x equal to b can be written as a equal to b raised to 1 upon x. So we are using that law over here. How it works is, in this step, you can multiply both the sides by the power 1 upon x. So x into 1 upon x. So these two terms will get cancelled. Over here we'll get it as 1. So 1 into 1 upon x. So in this b term, you'll get it as b raised to 1 upon x. So similarly, consider b raised to y equal to c, and using the same law, we can write b as c raised to 1 upon y. So from this step, we know that a is equal to b raised to 1 upon x, but we know that b is equal to c raised to 1 upon y. So in place of b, we are substituting the b value, which is nothing but c raised to 1 upon y whole raised to 1 upon x. So we'll get it as, so here a, we are substituting the b value in this term, so we'll get it as a is equal to c raised to 1 upon y whole raised to 1 upon x. So again using the law we can write it as c raised to 1 upon x into y. But we know that it is given a is equal to c raised to z. So here a I can write it as c raised to z, which is equal to c raised to 1 upon x into y. Again by using the law we can write c as c raised to 1 upon x y z. So in the first class again we had seen a raised to x equal to b raised to y. If the both the terms are equal, then we can say the powers are also equal, that is x is equal to y. So here the power is 1. So using that law we can write it as 1 upon x y z equal to 1. So when you cross multiply you'll get it as x into y into z is equal to 1. So with this we'll complete the topic of indices. I hope you guys are clear with all the problems. So today I'll be giving the notes, and from tomorrow we'll begin the next part of first unit, that is logarithms. I want you guys to have a logarithm table with you all. If you don't have a book, then you can download it from the Google. So these are all the problems of indices I have solved.